Hi guys, I just wanted to take you through that same tutorial we did in class today. So the first thing we're going to do is in Photoshop, I'm going to open that logo that was the other kind. That was black and we needed it to be white. So here we've got that logo. Notice that it has this checkerboard pattern in the background, which means that it is transparent. So I could go through and highlight each thing. With the magic wand tool, hold down shift and I get all these different pieces. But that takes forever and I don't want to do that. You could also select pieces by just searching for those pieces, but that's not what we're going to do here. In this case, I'm just going to select all of this and then go to image and then adjustments and invert, and that's going to switch the black to white. If this is any color, there's the opposite of that color, and so that's what this is doing, is it's just giving us the opposite. So I'm going to save this as a different file. Notice that it's in the same file folder, and that will be our logo, the largest file size here, and then I can close that out. I'm not going to save this because I want to keep the black version as well. Okay, so now we have that in here. Here's the white one. And so I'm going to go into Premiere first, and then I'm going to go into After Effects from there. So in Premiere, it's giving me these annoying beginning windows, but I'm going to create a new project, and I'm going to call this Jane Julia Studios video. And you can see I've got my location here, which is already set to Jane Video, but I could change it if not. Make sure that you have all of your files in the same file folder. That will make a really big difference. So once that's done, it will open up this workflow space. And I'm going to shrink this down a little bit just so I can see things a little bit more clearly. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add in my media here. So I'm going to grab my file folder and just drag the wall and my music and this image. Sorry, the video, the music, and the image all into my media. I'm not going to drag the logo in because I'm going to do that in After Effects itself. So I'm going to create a sequence. I'm going to click here. File, new sequence. Like I said, I normally prefer to do a digital SLR sequence at 30, but it's not really going to matter in this case because I'm using an existing asset and I'm not going to worry about timing either. This is a very long video. This is set to be a 10-minute long video. And obviously, my video is only going to be 30 seconds. But I'm going to leave it at as is. So now that I've got this sequence, I can rename it if you want to. So you go to sequence and sequence settings, and then I can change it. Although maybe I can't change it from here. Maybe it's just here. All right, for some reason I thought that you could rename the sequence. And I can't remember how to do it, but it doesn't really matter for the purposes of this, so I'm not gonna bother with it. Although it's really strange, I thought you could do that very, very easily. But I'm gonna just start this process here, and then we can go into After Effects. So I'm gonna pull in my main video, and I'm gonna allow it to change the sequence to match the clip settings. So I'm going to change the sequence settings. And you can see for some reason when I'm on the video on this exported video, this looks really weird. I don't know why that is. It's just the way it is. If it's being a little slow, you can always change this to half or a quarter. Notice this yellow line here. This says that it's mostly rendered, and that means that it will play smoothly. If it's red, then it won't play smoothly. So right now I press space bar and it will play smoothly. But if it was red, it wouldn't, and so you'd want to press enter instead of space bar, and that would allow you to go more smoothly through there. So I want to add my music as well. although I'm going to mute that so that when I'm playing back and forth, I won't have to deal with the music. And I'm going to add the image that I want at the end. I want this to appear at the very end of the piece. Notice it snaps to the end of that, but if I want it to appear on top, I can just move my little blue marker here, and then it will snap to the blue marker, and that's actually what I want. So notice that the image is too big, so I'm going to zoom out to, looks like, about 10%, and within the sequence here, this preview, I'm going to double click and you can see it's huge. So I'm going to resize that. Remember to hold shift down, although in this case, because it's an image, it doesn't really matter. And I'm going to resize that to about the same size as the sequence, at least the same size as the sequence. Okay, so that's basically what I want. I'm going to return to fit. You can see this is on top. Because it's on top down here in your sequence, it's also on top when you're previewing. Okay. So I want to add in the titles, and I'm going to do those in After Effects. So I'm going to go into After Effects. I'm going to make a new composition. I'm going to call this Jane Titles. Everything else is fine. It's 1920 by 1080. It's 30 seconds, which is too long, but that doesn't matter. And I'm going to leave my background as black, although again, that doesn't really matter because it's not really the background color. It's just the workspace that you're working in. I prefer black. Okay, so from here, I need to put in that logo. So I'm going to go back in and I'm going to just drag in that white logo. Now, if this doesn't work for you, and I remember some of you in class, it didn't work, you can always go to File and Import and go to Import File and do the same thing. You can go to the desktop or wherever you are, and then you can import that logo. And that will work that way too. I don't know why it wasn't working in the computer lab. So I'm gonna resize this and again, hold down shift. That's about the size I want it. I'm also going to move that up. And if I hold down shift while I'm moving it up, it will keep it along the same up and down, same vertical and horizontal. So I don't have to worry about that too much. Okay, so once that's done, I'm going to insert a text layer by clicking on the text tool here, type anywhere, and I'm going to do Halloween mural, October 2018. Now, this is already about the size that I want it, and it's already centered, but if I needed to center it, I would go over to paragraph and then center, and if I needed it to be bigger or smaller, I would go to character. So I'm going to click out of, so you can highlight to change the size. So I could, like, if I wanted this, let's say I want Halloween mural to be a little bit bigger. I could go over the size here and then I'm just going to click and drag to the side and I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. And I'm going to make the mural a little, or the October 2018 a little smaller, just to show you how that works. So I'm going to click out of this. And then I'm going to click on the layer. And what that does is it will actually select all of this stuff so I don't have to highlight it. And then I'm going to go to Align, and then Align to the center of the composition. And that's fine. So that looks okay. I think this the logo is a little small. Notice I clicked on here with the Type tool, and it created an empty text layer. So I'm going to click here again and delete it. You have to click on the layer you want. You can see that's done. And then you want to click on the Selection tool, and that will allow me to make it bigger or smaller. So I'm going to make that a little bit bigger. I'm also going to move this a little bit down. And then I'll move this a little down. And remember that if you click and then hold shift, it'll move it along that vertical axis or that horizontal axis. Okay, so this is fine. But the problem is here that this is all coming in at the same time. So I want the type layer to come in around 2 seconds in, and I want them both to fade at the same time. I want them both to fade in about 2 seconds. So I'm gonna expand this image out, expand transform, and then I wanna say about, let's say 1 second in. I can always change that if I want to, let's say 2 seconds. I want that to be at 100% opacity, so I click on the little animate button and notice it puts the keyframe there. I'm going to go back to the beginning and I'm going to change the value. Every time you change a value, it adds a new keyframe. And remember, I can always move these if I want to. They don't have to be static, so I can always change it. And then I want to do the same thing for the Halloween one. What I can do if I want this to be the same is actually copy it in and then paste it. And you'll see when I open it up that it's actually pasted in the exact same opacity or the exact same effect. Notice it's at a different time. So I want to highlight both of those keyframes. So just click and drag to highlight. And I'm going to move them in so that they start at 2 seconds. So now you can see what's going to happen at first when I press spacebar to preview, is that it's slowly going to fade in the title, and then it's slowly going to fade in the subtitle. Okay, so that's my intro, and I also want to make the outro, which will fade in as well. So I'm going to click on this layer, the Jane Julie Studios layer, and I'm going to copy it. So Control C or Command C. And then I'm going to make a new composition. And I'm going to call this outro. And you can see that's here. So this is Jane titles, which is not what I wanted. Actually, I shouldn't have done that in that way. So I'm going to go to composition settings and go call that intro. The project should be called Jane titles. So I'm going to save this as in the same thing, Jane titles. Okay, so now I've got this outro and I've copied, remember, Control C, I've copied this layer. I'm going to go to outro and I'm going to paste it in, Control V or Command V. And so notice that the effect came with it, and that's what I want. So this is done. I'm going to save it and I'm going to minimize just in case I want to change something again. And then when I'm back in Premiere, I can drag this Jane titles thing into import. And what it's going to do is it's going to bring up this import window and it's going to say, which composition do I want? And I want to take my intro and my outro. And After Effects looks like it might, or Premiere looks like it might have shut down. I don't know why, but that happens. So I'm going to open it back up. Okay. And so it looks like it didn't save any of the work that I did. That's wonderful. Okay, so sequence or file, new. You can see that these things just happen, and I was stupid because I didn't save it, right? So sequence name, I'm going to do it again, digital SLR, 1080p, 1080p 30. I'm going to leave that sequence name the same, and I'm going to import all of this stuff in together. So my three pieces here, then I'm going to save it, and then I'm going to import the titles. So I'm going to do the intro, and it will make me click it twice. I don't really know why it does that, but it does. And then I'm going to add the outro composition. And I was just double clicking there. So now I've got my intro and my outro. Okay, so I'm gonna put the intro in first. I'm gonna put that on video two because I want my video one to be the regular footage. I'm gonna zoom in here to about the 1 minute mark. It's about how long I want the video to be. I'm gonna put in my video itself. Actually, I'm gonna zoom back out. I forgot that the video was longer. I'm going to put in the video itself on video one, but I'll just leave that where it is. And then I want to do my outro here. And I'm going to put that one more up. And the reason I'm going to do that, of course, is because I'm going to put that image in. So I'm going to go a little bit in, put the image there. Now I have to resize that again. Okay, so that's done. I'm going to save it because I should have done that the first time. And then I'm going to toss my music in. Okay, so all of this is done. The one thing I do need to do is shrink this down. So I'm going to go to the time tool. So it's called the ripple edit tool. Hold it down and it should give you the rate stretch tool. So I've got my rate stretch tool here and I'm going to shrink this until it goes to the size I want, which is a little bit less than a minute long. Yeah, that's fine. It doesn't really matter because of what I'm doing, it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to go back to the select tool and I'm going to drag both of these over a little bit. Okay. So obviously my titles are too big, right? I'm going to mute that again. You can see that's about all I need. So I'm going to shrink it to that size. And here, I probably don't want this. That's faded in. That's where she gives us the thumbs up. So that's about where I'm going to fade that out. Okay, so this is basically the video. I'm going to go to a video transitions here, go to dissolve and cross dissolve, and I'm going to add a cross dissolve to my video, not to my title, except when it leaves, because I have it fade in After Effects. So I'm going to cross dissolve in and out for the image and for the video, and only cross dissolve out for the titles, because again, I've already done that in After Effects. So yes, I could have done this in After Effects instead of in Premiere instead of in After Effects, but I much prefer to do it this way because I never know where the end point is, but I always know where the beginning point is. So I want to be able to play with that in After Effects as I go. Okay, so once this is done, you can always preview it. So I'm going to fit, and you can see it fades in, then the subtitle fades in, then the video fades in, then the subtitle, then the titles fade out. Okay, and that's basically what I want here. All right, so what I need to do then is play with audio. And so I'm gonna drag this down so I can see it. And I'm gonna press Control or Command to get these little center lines. Once I'm over the center line, you can see it changes, and I'm gonna add these little keyframes. It doesn't really matter where I add them at this point. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit just so we can see what's going on. But really I'm just adding two keyframes for the beginning and the end. And so I know that at the end, I'm gonna let go of command. At the end, I want there to be no music. And I want the music to start fading out around here. This is personal preference, obviously. And I want it to start with no music. And I want it to fade into full music about where the video starts to fade in. So I've got this in and out. So if you take a listen, if I unmute it, take a listen. That's full volume. And then at the end, it will fade out. Okay. And of course, you can do that to reduce. If I wanted to have this with a roll, for instance, I would make 4 dots. And the reason is that I want to have this center point at about 50%. So you can drag each one individually, or you can just drag the center line. So always make 4 and then move the center line so you can see where it goes. And then, of course, you can choose where that is exactly, right? By moving these keyframes around. So that sounds like this. So it's at full volume, and then it goes down to 50%, stays at 50%, and at this point, it will go back up to 100. Okay, so I'm actually going to go through and press Shift. That was Control, which is not what I should have done. To delete those, that I just press delete there to delete them, and there we go. So now we have our audio and our video, and we're ready to export. So you can see how this is black, this is red, which means that it's not fully rendered, which means it's going to be a little choppy, but it doesn't really matter. So to export, you use these mark in and mark out if you just want part of the sequence, and because the sequence is 10 minutes long or whatever that is, 15 minutes long, I don't want to do that. I just want this minute. So I'm going to mark in, and then I'm going to move this, and I'm going to mark out. And I can move these. So at this point, I actually want to go from the very beginning to the very end, and it should snap. So that's going to be the end of the video. And so when I export, I go to File. Well, I'm going to save this first. File, Export, Media. And then I'm going to shrink this down a little bit because I can't see it. And I'm going to match the sequence settings. And then I'm going to, usually I would maximize render quality, but in this case it just doesn't really matter. And I am going to export. I'm going to change my output name to be the final video, or rough cut, I guess you could say. And that's in Jane Video, save, and then export. And you can see that this is actually rendering the audio first, and then it's going to render the video. And it's going to take a few minutes to do. This isn't actually that long, but so it's about 2 minutes to complete. Once that's done, you have a final video file, and it will appear in your, you can see it's already here, but it hasn't created it yet. It's not finished. Once that's rendered, then you can just upload it directly to YouTube. And that's it.